Tom Izzo and the Michigan State Spartans are headed back to the Final Four. How's that sound?
That sounds great, man, especially from you.
What are your emotions right now after that type of win with this group?
Well, I know how good Duke is, and I know how classy they are, and how good Mike is. And you know, I thought there was a couple times we might falter, but, you know, that's the way it's been all year for us. And in those huddles when we were down 30 to 21 and it looked like it was getting away, there's a calmness about Cassius, and McQuaid and Goins have been through it before, and, you know, they did a better job than I did handling it. But I think we've had this constant never give up, mentally tougher than maybe physically, and, boy, it was beautiful.
You sat right in the room behind us yesterday on Saturday and told us how badly you wanted to get back to the Final Four. What does this moment mean for you personally as the head coach of this program?
Well, whenever your program gets there, you realize how many of the people before, you know, we had Magic in there today. I had a bunch of former players flew in. You just kind of, so many of those guys, you know, thank me for what we did today, and I thank them because they built the thing. I'm just constantly trying to live up to the standards they set. And that's what's cool about when you've been in the same place a long time. You gather friends and you gather people that helped you create some memories that truly will last a lifetime. And each one's been different. But, boy, it's going to be hard to top this one. I'll tell you that, Marty.
This was a game of runs.
Yeah.
And they back and forth the entire night. What was your message to your team after Duke would go on one of those runs?
Well, I told him before the game, there's going to be some runs because Zion's going to get some breakaways. And if he starts dunking it, those are like double runs and because it energizes them. And, you know, I told him we were down 30-21. Okay, we had a little run early. They had their run. We got to have another run. And it was almost like they actually listened to me and they did it. You know, it was pretty cool. But I did think it was going to be a game of runs. They're explosive. When Barrett hit that big three, what a great play by them, and we were trying to find different ways to cover that ball screen. We finally switched it at the end, and it helped us a little bit, but we were making adjustments on the run, I promise you that.
Heading to Minnesota now, as you look forward, I know this just you just won this game, but as you look forward, what is this team's ceiling? How would you gauge your opportunity now?
Boy, I'd like to be a prophet and act like I really knew, but this team has superseded some of the thoughts I had about them, and yet I don't see why we should quit now. You know, I got to do a better job figuring out how do you get the eight of them and only win one. So the mission's going to be the coach got to figure some things out, or those players just got to drag me with and I go along for the ride.
Last thing, what was going through your mind when Kenny Goins' three left his hand?
You know, we did actually call somewhat of the play. They were really getting after Cassius. We said we'd blur the ball screen and hopefully they'd stay with Cassius, what they did. And he threw it back to him. And, you know, I did say to Kenny a couple times, are you going to make any shots today? You know, I mean, I have a sarcastic way of saying it once in a while. And he said, I'm making the next one. You know, and he did make one other big play, but he made the big shot. And for a guy that started out as a walk-on, I don't know, that storybook, you know, maybe you should make a movie on that 30 for 30.
I'm on it. He called his shot. Congratulations, Coach. I appreciate it.
Thanks,
enjoy
Marty.
This.
Appreciate you.
East Regional Most Outstanding Player, Cassius Winston. First, how do you describe your emotions right now?
Man, it's unreal. You know, just this is what we've been working for all year to get this opportunity, go to Final Four, win the championship, and had an opportunity in front of us. It's amazing.
We were just in Duke's locker room, and from Coach K down, everyone just gushed about your performance tonight. How would you describe your performance tonight?
Man, just, you know, that's what you do in big moments, you know. Just do everything you can to help your team win, and that was my whole goal tonight.
When you guys finally got in the locker room and got a minute together, what was that moment like?
It was crazy, you know what I'm saying? You just saw all the emotion, you know, all the work, all the time spent, you know, to have moments like that, and you're going to try to keep building on it.
You said to me a couple of days ago that the goal remains very simple, go win it all. You've now taken the next step. As you look forward to Minneapolis, what do you guys have to do to ensure you win it all?
Make sure our defense travels. You know, we keep checking, keep getting out of transition, keep playing Michigan State basketball. I like our chances against any team.
Last thing, what does this moment mean for East Lansing and the Spartan Nation?
Man, just amazing. I know they've been waiting on this for a minute. Had a lot of good teams that had a chance to get here. You know, we finally got back to it, and now we got to finish it off.
Well, I do have to ask one more. What was going through your mind when that shot left Kenny Goins' hand?
Oh, man, I saw it in the air. I was like, oh, that's pretty. You know what I'm saying? I like that. It was a pretty shot, so I wasn't mad at it. And then, like I said, he earned that moment, so it was bound to go in.
Congratulations. Enjoy this.
Thank you.
Well.
Yes, sir.
See you guys in Minnesota.
Appreciate that.